Maturity duration or effective maturity. Now, as you know, bond price looks like this. It is not continuous compound. If we use continuous compounding, of course, the bond price should be look like this. T equals 1 to T, CT, and exponential of minus RT. So on the continuous compound, we have this one. Now, value weight of the cash flow. So for each cash flow, the present value of this cash flow is like this one, right? At time t, cash flow occurs by the amount of Ct, and we discount it back, then it is the present value of that particular cash flow. And if we add all the present value of cash flow, then it becomes bond price, right? It is sum of the all discounted cash flow. So if we calculate ratio between the particular present value of this particular cash flow and bond price, we can calculate, we can regard this one as the value weight of a particular cash flow. Value weight of particular cash flow. And the Macaulay duration is simply weighted duration. So each this at particular time t, at particular time t, cash flow, present value, this one, and the bond price, this one, so this weight. So this Macaulay duration is basically we multiply time and importance of that time. Importance is measured as the present value of cash flow occurring at time with total value of cash flow, which is bond price. So it is the basically weighted duration. Weighted time, and weight is given by the value of the cash flow. So the Macaulay duration, this one is called the Macaulay duration. This Macaulay duration is the weighted average, right? This weighted average. Weighted average term to the maturity of the cash flow from a bond. And the weight of each cash flow is determined by dividing the present value of the cash flow by the price.